write a check to the beauty parlor every month.
Yes, I know that. But they don't always have a little note in the back like this one. Dear teller, be a lamb and don't put this through till next month. Oh, hiya, Fred.
Hi, Rick.
Well, don't you look cute? What are you doing with that scarf on top of your head?
Oh, you mean this? I was cleaning the apartment and I didn't want to get any dust in my hair.
Every month, every single month, your bank account is overdrawn. Now, what is the reason?
You don't give me enough money?
I don't give you enough money!
Well, we both agree that must be the reason.
Well, tell me something, will you? How often is Ethel checking account overdrawn?
Never.
Never? How do you manage that?
It's easy. I never had enough money at one time to open a checking account.
What? Hey, listen, by the way, what do you know about rice?
Well, I had it thrown at me on one of the darkest days of my life.
The dipping. You say you've had experience.
Oh, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I'm a dipper from way back.
Yes?
They used to call me the Big Dipper.
Lucy!
Greetings, Gates. Let me some skin, boy. Hiya, Cats. Hiya. Where do I sit, Dad?
Lucy, I want to speak to you.
Later, Gator. I gotta get up here and get my kicks, man.
Lucy, you come on out of there.
Oh, let her play.
Yeah, you ought to hear me. You never heard me blow. I'm the wildest man. I'm wild, boy. I'm wild.
Hey, hear an A, please.
Make, but the one for me is...
Albert!
Is who? Is who?
Albert, are you coming?
I told you I'd be there in a minute.
Oh, for heaven's sake, Albert, go eat your lunch!
Now, honey, remember when we were married, you wanted to be joined together in matrimony. Yeah.
And as I recall, it was till death do us part.
Yeah, that's right.
That event is about to take place right now.
Now, Ricky?
Hey.
It's fantastic, Lucy. Ricky and Fred are cut out of the same mold.
Yeah, and they're getting moldier all the time.
We have become stuffy, moldy, and musty. We are knee-deep in a pool of stagnation. Now, what are we going to do about it?
Well, I don't know about the rest of you, but I'm going to go and take a shower.
Never mind being funny. Now sit down.
I are going to spend a week away from you and Fred.
You mean I won't see you for a whole week?
That's right.
And you won't see me for a whole week, Fred.
Well, I'll make the sacrifice.
Ethel,
huh?
Well, nothing personal, but I'm sick of the sight of your face.
Well, you should try it from out here looking at yours. If you think this is...
You know something, Fred? I hate to admit this, but I like to see Lucy tonight.
I can top that. I'd like to see Ethel.
You know, it isn't every day that Mr. and Mrs. Fred Mert celebrate their 25th wedding anniversary.
That's right.
Gee, that's such a long time. 25 years.
Yeah. 25 years?
Sounds longer when you say it.
Right? He ruined our TV set.
What do you mean, your TV set? We just gave it to you.
Yeah.
Well, a couple of Indian TV givers.
Yeah. Why didn't you just give us the set and keep your grubby Cuban paws off of it?
He can put his grubby Cuban paws any place he wants.
Oh, stay out of there.
Now listen, you ungrateful old goat.
It's even worse than I remembered.
Hey, honey, I got a wonderful surprise for you. Sit down, will you?
Sit down? On that? How could anyone possibly sit on that?
Well, honey, it's easy. You stand up here like this, and you bend your knees, and there you are, huh?
How's Ricky this morning?
He's dying.
That's good. I thought it might be something serious. Honestly, Ethel, why are men such babies? I wish I could get away with acting like that.
You said it.
Last week, Fred had a little headache and took to his bed, moaned he might not live through the night. You remember when I broke my ankle last year? He tried to get me out of bed the second morning to fix his breakfast. He said walking would help the bone heal.
Lucy!
Pardon me, Ethel. I'm wanted in surgery.
I'll go scrub up in case you need me.
Babaloo! Babaloo!
That's pretty babalousy.
Never mind.
I want to get a checkup. I need a tonic or something. I've been feeling real dauncy.
Dauncy?
Yeah, that's a word my grandmother made up for when you're not really sick, but you just feel lousy. Oh. A baby?
Yeah, baby. That's a word my grandmother made up for tiny little people.
I never had a baby before. I've never been let in on it so soon. Let in on it? Why, you knew it even before I did. This whole thing was practically your idea.
I think that you know how tough my job is, but believe me, if you traded places with me, you'd be surprised.
Believe me, if I traded places with you, you'd be surprised. Count it all. After the baby's born, I'll just be forgotten.
Oh, that's not true.
It is too true. I'll be just like a salmon. I'll swim upstream, spawn, and never be heard.
Very funny.
Oh, you're a sore head.
Oh, now, Ricky, it's her condition.
It is not my condition. I was a sore head long before I ever thought about it.
It'll be the first time I ever heard a Cuban sing barbershop.
Well, yeah, a Cuban singing barbershop. That won't sound so right, will it? Well, I tell you what I'll do. I'll sing it with an Irish accent.
Oh, this I gotta hear.
Now, wait a minute. I'll practice. You'll be surprised.
That's for sure.
Oh. I certainly am. From the time our child is born, it's not going to hear anything but perfect English.
Well, honey, it's a very nice thought, but as usual, you will have no logical explanation for doing it the way you're doing it.
What did you say?
You heard what I said.
As usual, there's no logical explanation for doing it the way you're doing it. Ricky, promise me something.
What?
Promise me that until our child is at least 19 or 20 years old, you won't talk to it.
Who's going to play the fourth guy, Ricky?
Well...
Good night, ladies. Good night, ladies.
Good night.